Let's create a very basic, semantically correct layout incorporating HTML5 meaningful semantic elements. Divs, as we know, are generic containers that have absolutely no meaning to search engines, whereas HTML5 semantic elements have meaning to search engines. Divs can still be useful when we need a generic container or when there's no semantic element that serves the same purpose. In fact, I'm going to start out with a div. I'm going to put all of my semantic page content inside a generic div that I'm going to name container. And this is because it's going to make it much easier for me to control the content of my page. At the top of the page in the main Dreamweaver menu, I'm going to click Insert, Div. Now I already have my mouse positioned between the body opening and closing tag and the insertion div pop-up window is asking me if I want to insert at the insertion point, which I do. And I'm going to name this div container after I type the div class name. And we're trying to avoid as much as possible using IDs. Classes can be used multiple times on a page. IDs, along with being very limited in use since you're only to use them once per page, also have so much specificity value they can be bullies. So the best purpose for IDs is when you need anchors within a page, but we're going to avoid using them and opt for classes instead whenever we can. And I've named this div container. I'm not going to add a CSS rule at this time, and I'm going to click OK. Inside the container, I'm going to insert a header. I'm not going to give that a class name. I want it to be after the start of the tag. I'm going to click OK, and then it didn't go where I wanted to go, and sometimes that happens. So I'm going to take my mouse, and I'm going to just delete the content. You should be able to just make sure your mouse is positioned between the opening and closing tag and place it. Sometimes it doesn't work. So now I'm going to go insert and I'm going to click header. And I want it at the insertion point. Okay. So inside the header, I want an H1 tag. I should be able to go insert heading H1 and I can. That worked perfectly. So now outside of my header is where I'm going to put my navigation. I'm going to go insert, navigation, and insertion point. Yep, that's where I want it. Okay. Now, I'm just going to use links for this navigation. I'm not going to use an unordered list. Prior to HTML5, to give your navigation some sort of semantic structure, it was recommended that you always use lists. You can still use lists inside of a nav, but you don't have to anymore. You aren't limited to that. And so since it's easier to style when I want horizontal navigation, since it's really easier to style just as a link, that's what I'm going to do. So after the navigation, I'm going to insert my main content area at the insertion point, making sure that it's inside that div. Inside my main content area, I want a heading 2 first off, and then after my heading 2, I'm going to delete that content. I'm going to just put heading 2, okay, and after the heading 2, I'm going to insert a section, and I just want that at the insertion point. And then inside of that section, I'm going to insert, first of all, a heading 3, and then I'm going to replace that text with heading 3. Okay, when you do this, you have to be careful that you don't do what I just did and break part of my tag. So I saw that I'd done that and I was able to fix it. You want to keep an eye on that when you're creating this. Now, after the H3, I'm going to insert a paragraph, and inside that paragraph, I'm going to insert some lorem ipsum. So I'm just going to delete this text content that's highlighted. And I'm going to type LOREM. I'm taking advantage of Emmet. That's a built-in shortcut little mini text editor. I'm going to type lorem and 50 without a space. Then I'm going to hit my tab key. It's going to give me some lorem ipsum. And then after this section, I want another section just like it. So I'm just going to highlight this section from opening tag to closing tag. I'm going to copy and I'm going to paste. And then actually I think I want one more just like that. Copy and I'm going to paste. And that's going to be all for my main content area. After that, I'm going to have an aside, because on either the right or the left, I'm going to have a sidebar. So I'm going to go insert, I'm going to come to aside, and I want to add the assertion point, which is after the main closing tag, before the div closing tag. I'm going to click OK. Then I'm going to delete that content area, and I'm going to insert an H3 heading tag. OK. And after the H3 heading, I'm going to insert an ordered list. And again, I'm going to take advantage of a nifty little emmet shortcut. I want 7 list items, so I'm going to type in between my ordered list opening and closing tag li, and then I'm going to use the asterisk as the time, and I'm going to type 7. I'm going to tap the tab key, and now I have 7 items, and I'm just going to go back in so that I can see that they're there. I'm just going to put numbers. There's a way in the shortcut to do this, but I didn't want to take the focus away from the work at hand. Emmet is built into Dreamweaver and a lot of text editors that can be added as an add-in. It's a handy little shorthand feature. It's a handy little shorthand feature that can be used for HTML and CSS. It's free, it's easy, it's a lot of fun. And I encourage you to look into that to help speed up your creating of sites from scratch, which hopefully we'll never stop doing. Okay, so now I have 7 items in this list, and the only thing else I want to add right now is a footer. I'm going to hit the enter key one more time. I'm going to insert. I'm going to come down to footer, and yes, I want to add the insertion point, which is after my aside closing tag, before my div closing tag. I need to be very careful that things are placed correctly. I'm going to click OK. There's the content for the footer. The only thing I want to put in the footer is an H4 heading tag, and I'm going to replace that content with heading 4. So we have a basic layout. Looks kind of messy. Guess what? We can fix that. I'm going to click anywhere in the HTML, and I'm going to go to the icon just above the apply comment. I'm going to click on formatting. I'm going to click apply source formatting, and that's going to clean up my HTML, placing the indents appropriately so that it's easier for me to read. And what I have now is a properly formatted page that incorporates semantically correct HTML5.